Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel sonisinghphysics. In this video we are going to talk about current, voltage and resistance. This video is going to be very suitable for the students of grade 8 or those who are in Cambridge checkpoint. Students who follow Collins book, Hodder's book, this video is going to be very useful for them. The whole discussion will complete with the help of questions, so let us watch it. Current is rate of flow of electron or amount of charge flowing per unit time. Voltage is amount of electrical energy supplied by a source or electrical energy consumed by a component, whereas resistance is obstruction produced in the path of current. So we are going to see the relation between current, voltage and resistance through these questions. Let us see that. First question is, in which circuit is the lamp brightest? Now look at the circuit diagram given here. In circuit 1, there is a cell, a resistor and a bulb. In second one, there are two resistors in parallel. And in third one, there are three resistors in parallel. So as per parallel combination of resistors, when we increase the number of resistors in parallel, the overall resistance of the circuit will decrease. So in this way, circuit 3 will have least resistance compared to 2 and 1. So the bulb present in circuit 3 will be brighter compared to other two. So answer will be circuit 3. We can understand this with the help of an example also. Through this example, we will understand that how brightness of this bulb will affect when there are more number of resistors in parallel. We have to assume that each of the bulb are identical, it means they will consume same amount of electrical energy, and each resistors are also identical, each is having capacity 1 ohm. So now we'll see what will be the total resistance in each circuit. So in circuit 1, total resistance will be 1 ohm because there is just one resistor. In second circuit, there are two resistors in parallel, so we'll calculate total resistance of this circuit. So as per formula for parallel connection, it will be 1 by R will be equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1, because the formula for total resistance is equal to 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 and so on. So I have taken like this. Now what will happen? It will be, we'll solve it mathematically, it will be 2 by 1. So 1 by R is equal to 2 by 1. R will be equal to 1 by 2. You can take it reciprocal. So in second circuit, total resistance will be equal to 1 by 2, that is 0.5 ohm. Now we'll move on to circuit 3. We'll use the same formula to calculate total resistance over here. So 1 by R will be equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1. So 1 by R will be equal to 3 by 1. And when we take it reciprocal, R will be equal to 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 will be, it will be 3.33 something. So in this way, if you look at the total resistance of circuit 3, that is the least, 0.33 ohm. So then this bulb will glow brightest compared to bulb of circuit 2 and circuit 1, because the total resistance of the circuit 3 is least. In this question, as resistors are added in series to a circuit, the total resistance will. So as we know, in a series circuit, the total resistance will be addition of all the resistance. So here it will be increases. When we add more resistors in series, the total resistance will increase. Move on to fourth question. As the resistance of a resistor in series increases, the measured voltage across that resistor will. So when the resistance increases, the voltage will increase as per Ohm's law. V is equal to IR, V will be directly proportional to I and R also. So when the resistance increases, voltage across that resistor will also increase. Next question is, if you have three 1.5 volt batteries in series, what would be the total voltage will? So when we add more than one batteries in series, the total voltage will get added up. So here answer will be 4.5 volt. In this question, in an electrical circuit, electrons move from. So in electrical circuit, electron direction is negative to positive, whereas as per conventional current rule, current direction is positive to negative. In this question, look at the circuit diagram. When the switch is closed, the iron nail attaches to the steel clips. Why? Now look at the options. Why iron nail will attach to the steel clips? First option is the iron nail produced electric current to attract the steel clips. Second is the iron nail became a magnet and attracted to the steel clip. Iron nail is a conductor of electric current in the circuit. So here the correct answer is the iron nail became a magnet and attracted the steel clips. So here iron nail will behave like an electromagnet, and you know that electromagnet is artificial magnet, and we can increase the strength of magnet by increasing the amount of electricity passed through it. We can increase the strength by increasing the number of turns also, and we can increase the strength by changing the core material with the soft iron core. So electromagnet is an artificial magnet which strength can be controlled by us as per our requirement. In this question, thin metal wire inside the electric bulb is, that is called filament. You can see in this picture. This question is based on Ohm's law, and question is, a circuit has 120 volts and a 45 ohm resistor. How much current is there? So as per Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, and then I will be equal to voltage by resistance, that is 120 by 45, and our answer will be 2.7 ampere. Ampere is SI unit of current. In this question, what is voltage? Voltage is the flow of electron. No, it is current. Current is the flow of electron. Then electric potential difference. Yes, voltage is electric potential difference. Then what is the fourth option? The ability to reduce the flow of electrons. What is it? This is resistance. So the correct answer for this question, what is voltage? Answer is, it is a electric potential difference. In this question, how many volts would it take to push 1 ampere through a resistance of 1 ohm? This is also based on Ohm's law. And here you need to calculate voltage, and as per formula, V is equal to IR. So volt will be equal to 1 ampere into 1 ohm. Our answer will be equal to 1 volt. Volt is SI unit of voltage. In this question, what size resistor would produce a 3 ampere current flow with a 12 volt battery? So here we have to calculate size of resistor, that is R, and R will be equal to V by I, that is 12 by 3, and answer will be 4 ohm. Ohm is SI unit of resistance. In this question, the rate at which electrons move through a circuit is, so that is called current. Current is rate of flow of electron in a given time. In this question, an example of a voltage source is, so that is battery. Battery provide voltage in any electrical circuit. 15th question is, in a parallel circuit with two light bulbs, if you take one light bulb, what will happen to the other bulb? Since it is a parallel circuit, the other bulb will stay on, it will not get affected. In this question, an accumulation of electrons on an object is known as. So what is known as? That is called static electricity. Accumulation of electrons is known as static electricity, whereas flow of electrons is known as current electricity. In this question, what is used to measure the flow of current in a circuit? So now look at all these four. First is ammeter. So ammeter is used to measure the flow of current. Battery is used to provide voltage in the circuit. Rheostat is a variable resistor, and voltmeter is used to measure voltage in a circuit. So correct answer is ammeter. In this question, if you decrease the voltage of a circuit, what happens? So there are four options. When we decrease voltage, what will happen? Current decreases, current increases, electrons disappear, bulbs get brighter. So correct answer will be, as per relation of Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So when voltage decreases, then current will also decrease in the circuit, and first option will be correct answer. Next is, if you decrease the resistance, that is amount of light bulbs of a series circuit, what happens? So when you are decreasing resistance, then current will increase. In this question, what happens to the current when you add more light bulbs to a parallel circuit? So in a parallel circuit, when we are adding more light bulbs, that will be maybe in terms of resistor. So what will happen? Overall resistance of the circuit will decrease and then current in the circuit will increase.